Arcangelo Corelli, an Italian composer and violinist, played a significant role in shaping modern genres such as sonata and concerto, establishing the violin's preeminence and laying the foundation for modern tonality and functional harmony. Our next piece, the Folia, employs a popular chord progression that many Renaissance and Baroque composers use as the foundation for variations and improvisation. It originated in the dance musical of Portugal. Please join me in welcoming Rachel Weiss to perform for you La Folia.
Thank you.
Bach's profound admiration for Italian music is unmistakable in the way he transcribed Vivaldi's Concerto for Two Violins and String Orchestra in A minor, ingeniously adapting it for the organ.
Thank you. Thank you.
Couperin was a French Baroque composer, organist, and harpsichordist. He was known as Couperin the Great to distinguish him from the other members of the musically talented Couperin family. His notable works include two masses for organ, which alternate with the Gregorian chant. Today, Mr. Salcedo will perform the offertory from the Mass of the convent.
Thank you.
next piece is the only one that is outside of the Baroque style. Charles de Beria was born in 1802 in Belgium into a noble family, but was orphaned at age of 9. He was given to the custody of his music teacher. De Beria and Niccolo Paganini careers ran parallel for many years, even though De Beria was 20 years younger than Paganini. And now, please welcome Elena Simon to perform the Violin Concerto No. 9 by Charles Auguste de Beria.
Thank you.
Before we listen to our very last piece, we would like to thank all of you for your attendance today. Thank you also to our pastor, Father Danda, and our associate pastor, Father Clausen, for all their support which makes these concerts possible. Some documents state that Johann Sebastian Bach wrote the fantasy to test the strength and capacity of a new pipe organ. In different documents, we can find that Bach improvised the fugue in 1729 during an audition for an organist position in Hamburg. It is not clear whether the practice of coupling the fantasia with the fugue derives from the composer himself. Bach's manuscripts are not clear on this matter. The truth is that normally this fantasy and this fugue are usually played together. And now let's listen to Mr. Salcedo perform the fantasia et fugue in G minor by Johann Sebastian Bach.
Thank you. see you on December 12th. We will have the symphonic band coming to play, so for Christmas concert, December 12th at 7 p.m. Thanks so much for coming.